Wrestling Rampage here, back with another exciting video.
That's right, we are back with another video. This is Wrestling Rampage. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, facebook.com/wrestlingrampage. Shake your leg number two.
Hey.
Follow us on Twitter at Wrestle Rampage. Hit that subscribe button. We got more videos coming.
That's
right. We always got more videos
That's
coming.
Right.
This is.
They're right.
This is. Five questions with Wrestling Rampage. That's right. Five. But there are six this week.
Oh, man.
Well, this time around, there's six. And guys, thank you so much for you guys sending in your questions. Actually, we had so many questions that we actually had to do a three series of five questions. So.
But we don't mind it at all. Ask us anything you want. As long as you know it ain't... too personal.
With that being said, we'll go ahead and get started. First question is by Radical Velocity, which won the DDP giveaway contest. I hope you're enjoying the DVD. First question is: who got the bigger push, John Cena or Roman Reigns?
I'm gonna have to go with Roman Reigns.
Why's that?
Because.
Well, you need to go in depth on your little decision.
Reason. All right, actually, John Cena worked his way up to get where he was. You know, he started at the very bottom. You know, he was the job guy for Angle. And actually, I put on a really good match with Kurt in his debut. And was wearing the goddamn hometown shorts, you know. And then he made it up
the
to
prototype make, shorts from yeah. from
and then W. And then he moved up to mid card, started doing the rap and stuff as a heel, and taking
United
on
States
mid card guys like a Rikishi and all those.
Then he won the United States
and
Championship.
Then he won the United States Championship, and then eventually he won the WWE Championship. So he actually started at the bottom, and then worked his way
well,
up.
What's your decision on? On Roman Reigns get the bigger
push. Roman Reigns started right at the top. He came in with the fucking Shield. The two workers, Dean Ambrose and Seth Rollins, not him. And he was mooching off their success. And then the Shield broke up. Mm-hmm. And then Roman Reigns foundering in the mid-card. Actually, foundering, in my opinion, because I think he sucks. He's still foundering today, in my opinion.
And notice he never changed.
He's never changed. He comes out to the fucking Shield music that's been there since 2013 or 12, whatever the fuck year it is. And fucking comes out almost with the same goddamn vest. And comes out with the same goddamn fucking security guard pants. And the fucking security guard boots and the goddamn fucking security guard gloves. He's the same. He's the same like he was with the Shield. He's plain. And he sucks. And Roman Reigns, if there's Roman Reigns fans out there, I don't give a shit. I just tell you how it is. To me, Roman Reigns sucks. So, and to be honest, that's my opinion. That's my thoughts on that.
Pops, who got the bigger push?
John
Cena or Roman Reigns?
Roman Reigns got the bigger push. For the fact of this right here, you know, I agree with some of the things Tommy says, but everybody has to come from somewhere, just like Cena's dad owned the Federation of his own. He owned a little territory. That's where Cena got his start. Then OBW picked him up.
Well, you
yeah, I go by the facts. Everybody starts somewhere. You can't knock a guy for starting. You know, you can knock what he does when he gets in there.
You can knock if you don't have talent, too.
Well, I mean, Cena does 5-6 moves, so I guess... You know, I never liked Cena when he come in as a fucking prototype from OVW. So, but Roman Reigns did get the bigger push, but trouble is they're pushing the wrong fucking way. They're trying to cram him down everybody's fucking throat with this right here goody two shoot motherfucking shit. What I've said before is that you turn the motherfucker heel just like I said. Let the motherfucker enjoy his heelness. Take the fucking enjoyment of it. But make people hate you. Make people want to get out of the stands and hurt you. That's what a fucking heel's supposed to do. That's your fucking job.
So you think Roman Reigns got the bigger push?
He got a bigger push. As a matter of fact, they're getting so bigger push, they're pushing him down his throat, and that's why people are hating him right now.
This is a tough question to answer. Cena did get a push, a big push. Now, I will say this. When he won the WWE Championship to that point, he got it good, okay? Now, after he won the WWE title for the second time, it went down big time. Because he was winning every goddamn match against every fucking person that he fucking went against. That's why his nickname was Super Cena.
Yeah.
Now, Roman Reigns, playing out, most people don't like him.
That's it.
And I'm going to go with Cena got the bigger push after the world title. After he won the WWE title for the second time. What is he now? 16? So, there you go. But Roman, I just never liked him. Plain and simple. I didn't like him when he was with the Shield. I don't like him now.
Well, I don't lie. I don't particularly hate the guy. I hate Cena because I think Cena's a fucking little punk.
See, I hate Roman Reigns.
You see, what the deal of it with me is you see, they come in with Cena just like you said. He's unbeatable and can't be beat and shit like that right there. I mean, he won fucking matches that are unfucking believable. It's a fucking cartoon character with that fucker.
Well, this actually ties in with the first question, which is asked by TN Couponer. If Reigns versus Cena, if Roman Reigns versus John Cena ever happens, who gets booed the most?
Roman Reigns. Roman Reigns. Simple, Roman Reigns.
I will have to say Roman Reigns, not because of the fact that he's going against fucking Cena. The fact of it is, everybody boos him anyway because
yeah, but people boo John Cena when he gets out there too.
Yeah, and say Cena sucks.
Yeah, with the theme song, Cena sucks.
And to be honest, I don't think people would even give a fuck about that match anyway.
That'd be a Goldberg versus Lesnar match for the third fucking time. That's what that match would be.
Yeah, and people just boo both of them, to be honest with you.
But you think Roman would get booed, though?
Yeah. He'll probably get booed the most, if I had to choose. But, of course, Cena will get his boos, too.
Oh, yeah, of course.
But pops.
Just like I said, I think Roman Reigns gets booed more because he's booed anyway. It doesn't matter what they do because, you know, just like I said, the bees kind of cramming down everybody's throats, and that's why I think everybody hates him. Everybody boos.
I have to agree with you on that too. I'm gonna go with Reigns gets booed the most if that encounter ever happened.
Although I must say this, I mean, the rest of the time I say this right here, I wouldn't really give a shit about the match.
Nobody will. It's Goldberg versus Lesnar. Nobody gives a shit right there. With that being said, Reigns will get booed the most. And also, you gotta look at it this way. When Cena first started coming up in the main event picture, he was brought up the right way, coming to the main event status. But when he stayed in main event status, that's when it went down.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Roman is introduced to a whole group of new fans. And mainly it's internet fans.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm about to say he's going to get booed the most.
That's it.
Cena at that time, he came up in the same way, but back then social media was a little harder to come by than nowadays.
Yeah. It was kind of almost non-existent.
You know, back when Cena was coming up, there was no Twitter, there was no Facebook.
No.
There was I believe MySpace was still around at that point. But, MySpace was the biggest one that they had at that point, and, I mean, you could write your little comments
little
or whatever.
Comments
but,
and everything like that right
but,
there,
you know, yeah. it didn't take off as much as it did.
Yeah.
That's why I think Roman gets more hate than Cena did at that point. I mean, maybe if there were social media more prominent back then, you might see that with Cena. I mean, you see it with him now because he's been on top for fucking 12, 13 years. Next question, asked by Evil Nerd. If you guys were in a Survivor Series elimination tag match, 6 versus 6, who would you want on your team?
Stone Cold Steve Austin. Ric Flair.
Oh, hold on. So you want Stone Cold?
Yep.
We'll do this around table real fast. Yeah. Now, that being said, you can't choose another person that on their team. Okay. So 6, 6, 6. We'll do fucking triple five. Threat fucking.
And you can only choose five. It's one of us.
Five. Exactly. Yeah, so you want Stone Cold as your first member.
Yeah.
Dad, who do you want on yours?
I'll tell you what, I'm going to, you know, is this a fantasy thing?
We're going to go fantasy. I don't know if it, like, the question was never actually specifically answered for this generation or whatever, so we're going to go with fantasy.
Okay, then I can get this right here a lot better. Well, I could get it without it, but I think the true facts of it is, hey, my first pick would be the Reverend Wolverine.
Chris Benoit.
The Crippler, baby. Because he would get in there and cripple.
Shawn Michaels. No brainer.
Ric Flair.
Edge.
Chris Jericho.
Kevin Owens.
Sami Zayn.
Fuck it, I'm gonna go with it. Triple H.
Bray Wyatt.
Seth Rollins.
Mr. Perfect.
And my last one is going to be... Fucking Randy Orton.
Dead.
My last pick would have to be... Nakamura.
Undertaker. So who do you think will win that Survivor Series match? Tommy, go ahead and list off all yours.
Stone Cold. Ric Flair. Kevin Owens. Bray Wyatt. Randy Orton.
And yourself.
And myself.
Pops?
Oh, shit, I bet five of them got.
Pops forgets a lot of things.
Yeah, I
know
that. Yeah, I do. I think it was
Seth Rollins, Shinsuke Nakamura, yourself,
Edge,
Chris Benoit.
Yeah.
So me, I'm gonna go with Shawn Michaels, Chris Jericho.
It's hard to remember all the names.
Damn, who was the other one that I listed? I forgot.
Mr. Perfect,
and then the Undertaker. So,
now, can you imagine all that talent in one ring? It would be it would be a fight to the finish.
Let us know in the comments below who would win that that Survivor Series elimination tag match. Here comes the fourth question. We actually have 6 questions this week, but asked by Hayden Huffman, what do you guys think about WWE announcing the return of Bad Blood as a Raw exclusive pay per view?
To be honest, I think Bad Blood sucks.
The first one was
the 97,
In Your
and
House.
The only good match was Shawn and Undertaker on a Cell. Mm-hmm. To me, Bad Blood was not a really good fucking pay-per-view to me.
Cool name, but this is the simple fact of how it's going to be used today.
And Shawn Michaels and Triple H in 04, mm-hmm. 03, you can't remember.
I mean, I enjoyed Bad Blood, you know, as a pay-per-view. And they did use it, there was a lot of blood, but how is it going to be used now with it being called Bad Blood, and they have a rule against blood now?
I don't like.
And see, there's more better goddamn pay-per-view names they had before. They're better than that. Fuck, I'll take an In Your House over fucking Bad Blood any day.
Vengeance.
Vengeance,
they can go back to the fucking Roadblock, bro. I care.
Roadblock
sucks,
by the way. Yeah. That's already now.
That's one of the worst ones.
You know,
well, God damn it, ain't no worse than Bad Blood.
Vengeance, Armageddon's a pretty good
Armageddon, one. Yeah.
No
Way Out.
No Way Out's a good one. You know,
Backlash.
They got Backlash.
Yeah, they just brought that one back, last year. But
even the Great American Bash.
Well, you know how Vince is.
He don't use nothing that he didn't. That he didn't make.
It's better than fucking Bad Blood.
Man, well, see, I just don't think it's gonna work now as a pay per view called Bad Blood because they don't like for their wrestlers to bleed, and when they do bleed, of course the ref's gonna put on the fucking surgical gloves,
and then they stop the match,
and then they stop the match to wipe the blood off and everything else. So I don't think it's gonna work too well, but that's just me.
Don't like it when you hear something titled Bad Blood. You know, you think, oh damn, this is gonna be always gonna be blood in it. Just like you're supposed to hear a steel cage match, you don't see no blood there either. I think it sucks. I think it's fucking ridiculous. If you ain't gonna do what the marquee says, don't fucking do it.
If you're not gonna do what it's merited to do, don't fucking promote it. That's just the way it goes. Fifth question. Asked by Charles Reed Fowler, why does Undertaker's American Badass / Big Evil gimmick get hated on? He loved it.
I don't know. I loved it too. I don't know why it gets shit on, because I actually liked that year when the Undertaker was the American Badass and Big Evil. I loved it when he beat up David Flair. That was awesome. I loved it when he was undisputed champion in 2002 with that. And you're going to learn to respect authority. I enjoyed that era of The Undertaker, to be honest with you.
And that was...
And to be honest, the dead man was kind of... The dead man, you know, when he was doing that, was kind of getting stale. And you know, that's probably why he did the American Badass gimmick. To be honest, I enjoyed it.
I didn't care too much for Ministry Undertaker.
I didn't either.
The Lord of Darkness Undertaker. I just didn't enjoy it all that much.
I wasn't a big fan of that one either.
Yeah, you know, of course, if you have Minion on your fucking team, I don't want to be a part of that either. But, Undertaker's American Badass gimmick, the American Badass gimmick was alright, but when he switched over to just Big Evil, I like the Big Evil. I know he came out with, you know, the Kid Rock's American Badass. Then he went to Roland with Limp Bizkit. Now, it wasn't until he changed his theme to You're Gonna Pay. Big Evil, Dead Man Inc. That's the Taker I really enjoyed. But, I mean, regardless, I've always liked Undertaker.
Yeah.
Regardless. You know, I didn't care too much for Ministry Undertaker, you know, just because it went to a different realm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, than you know, him coming out with coffins and all that stuff.
We're talking about the Undertaker. I mean, they've already got a wing made for him in the Hall of Fame already. You know, here's what I say, you know, he's smart enough to know, you know, when it's time for a change, Reigns. He's smart enough to know that. What you know is getting to be like Tommy says, you know, stale. He knows to change it. That's the spot. That takes a goddamn guy's been around a while, knows about wrestling, knows when it's time to change. Reigns.
Now with that, with the American Badass gimmick, it was an extension of his real personal self.
Yeah.
Undertaker is a biker.
Exactly.
He comes out, you know, he does have Harleys and things of that nature. He is a true biker. So, you know, accentuating more of his personality than, you know, the dead man character.
The dead man character, yeah.
You know, I don't know why it gets hated on a lot. I mean, I assume it's some people and, you know, just liked him as the dead man. Me, I enjoyed Undertaker all
the time. Like you said, you know, he took a part of himself and made it work for him. You know, and I
made him a big fan favorite at that point as well.
It did.
Because, you know, they were cheering for Undertaker, but, you know, he was the, you know, the dead man, you know, demonic character. So, you know, you know, this one, you know, he did a lot of American stuff, the American flag, things of that nature.
Well, he did. He brought people to knowing what he really was, you know. I mean, he's a biker. He knows about everything. Definitely knows about wrestling and everything. So I think, you know, that
legitimate tough badass as well.
Yeah, damn tough as hell. Yeah. And hell, I've always liked the Undertaker. No matter what he's done, I've always liked him. And he knows. He, like I said, he knows how to change. You know, he knows how to make himself better.
It's true. We're going to go into the final question. This is our sixth question, asked by Macy Grice. Your favorite horror movie? This is a non wrestling related question, and feel free to ask us.
Oh God!
I don't have one because I don't like horror movies. I said,
yeah, Tommy does not like horror movies.
He does not like I said. You know, people don't know these are my sons. And he has never liked horror movies in his life. He won't watch them. He just don't like them.
I don't.
But you will watch like murder mysteries and things of that nature on TV.
I just don't like horror movies.
Is it because it's not real?
It's fake.
It's fake?
Yeah. But I know people are going to say, well, wrestling's fake. But here's the difference. I like wrestling. I don't like horror movies.
Yeah.
Horror movies ain't my passion, okay? I don't want to see fucking Freddy Krueger dressed up like fucking someone, fucking fake killing somebody. If I want to see that, I'll watch my murder shows.
That's right, Forensic Files.
Yeah. Fucking New Detectives.
Snapped.
I'll watch stuff like that.
He watches the Justice Channel a lot.
Yeah, I watch all that.
So does this guy.
Yeah, I do too, but I also like horror movies too. Best horror movie. Is that what you?
Your favorite horror movie.
My favorite horror. God, you won't. Well, look. If I told you my favorite of all of them, we'd be here biggest part of the night. But I would have to say, going back, I would have to say the old shit's the best. The black and white shit. Frankenstein, the werewolf.
Of course, you go with
Dracula. The old shit is the best. It's the old black and white shit. And if it wasn't
so, did you not like any of the newer horror movies?
I like It. I like a Freddy. I like Jason. But
Halloween.
I like Halloween too. I also like, you know, the
Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
Yeah, love that. And there's a whole bunch of them I like. You know, it's Wrong Turn. Love that one.
You know, I enjoy some of the more mainstream ones. Texas Chainsaw Massacre, Freddy Krueger, Michael Myers, and of course Jason Voorhees. I got a Jason Voorhees doll sitting right up there on my entertainment center. And I also have the complete collection of Friday the 13th.
Yeah.
They know this. Walmart had a sale during Halloween, like all over like $5, and I bought every single one of them. So if I had to say my favorite Friday the 13th, Jason.
Yeah. Oh yeah. I forgot. I've got one. The black and white one. Creature from the Black Lagoon is a good one too.
1960s one.
Actually, it's from 1940.
Old shit. Well, that being said, they're old shit, right? That was 5 questions with Wrestling Rampage. Feel free to ask us any questions you guys want to. You can ask us through all our social media sites. Facebook.com/WrestlingRampage2. Follow us on Twitter at WrestleRampage. Hit that subscribe button. We got more videos coming, right?
A lot more.
That's right.
little WrestleMania from the WrestleMania shirt from 2 years ago. Let us out. Yeah, let me off again.
If you don't subscribe right here on Wrestling Rampage, you're a loser.